All right, here's an application in a chemistry example of utilizing the quadratic equation for some calculations. I need to introduce the idea of chemical equilibrium. In an equilibrium, you have a chemical reaction that's going both forward and backwards at the same time. And so we're seeing both the formation and the destruction of HI in this chemical equilibrium, and the rate forward is equal to the rate in reverse. In other words, HI is being formed at the same rate as it's being destroyed at equilibrium. So you have a stable concentration. The rate does depend on the concentration. And that lets us calculate rates, which lets us calculate an equilibrium constant. So let's start out with the idea that the rate forward equals the rate back. And the rate forward is going to be equal to the concentration of the reactants, which are H2 and I2, times some constant. I'm going to call that Kf. And the reverse rate is going to be equal now to Kr times the concentration of HI. But there's two HIs, so we're going to have HI times HI concentrations. Okay? Since rate forward equals rate back, then we can take this one step further and say Kf times H2 times I2 equals the K in reverse constant times HI, and I'm going to just say HI squared here. Okay, HI times HI, HI squared. Rearrange this equation to get the constants by themselves, and I am going to divide both sides by KR. So I've got KF over KR. And I also want to divide both sides by H2 and I2. So I wind up with my HI squared. Over H2, I2. Okay, and this equals something that we call KC. Little C there stands for concentration. Okay. And this gives us an equilibrium constant expression right there. HI squared over H2 and I2 equals KC. Now for this particular reaction, at 450 Celsius, KC is 50.5. Okay, so this is known, this is found from investigation, observation. So let's set up a problem here. 1 mole of H2 combined with 2 moles of I2. Now obviously these are going to react to form HI, right? And then the HI is going to decompose back to H2 and I2. The question is, what are the final concentrations? The temperature is going to be at 450, and we've got a 1 liter container, 1 mole of H2, 2 moles of I2. In other words, what are the final concentrations? I'm going to use a little chemistry trick here. We call this an ICE table for obvious reasons. The I stands for initial, the C is for change, and the E is for the equilibrium condition. And I'm going to write the reaction up here. We got H2. And I2 in equilibrium with two HIs. Okay. Initially, I don't have any HI. So that's zero. Initially, I have 1 mole and 2 moles. Okay. we're going to use X, this is the change, X is going to be consumed, and 2X is going to be formed. Okay, because we make two HIs, for every one H2 and one I2 is going to make two HIs. So my equilibrium condition is going to be 1 minus X for the H2, 2 minus X for the I2, and 0 plus 2X for the HI. Okay. Putting this in the equilibrium constant expression, Kc is the concentration of Hi squared divided by H2 times I2. Okay, so we expand this out a little bit. First of all, this equals 50.5, that's given. And this is going to be 4x squared. Don't forget to square the 2. And when I expand the denominator there, I get 2 minus 3x plus x squared. Okay. Rearrange things a little bit, and I get 50.5 equals 4x squared. Okay. And multiply that out. I'm going to get 101 minus 151.5x plus 50.5x squared. That all equals 4x squared. Subtract 4x squared from both sides. I'm setting this equal to 0 to get ready to use the quadratic. Okay. I'm going to move things around so I get 46.5x squared in the first position, minus 151.5x plus 101. And this gives me my A, B, and C for the quadratic equation. Okay. Plus or minus B squared minus 4ac, all divided by 2a. I know you know that. And this equals x, right? All right, so negative b is going to be 151.5, plus or minus, and if I solve under the radical there, I get 64.54. all divided by 2 times A, which is 2 times 46.5, or 93. Okay. So there's two possible roots here. There's the plus and the minus. If I add 64.54, x equals 2.32. If I subtract, then x equals 0.935. Now if we look back at the original equation here, let's see, we've got a 1 minus x term and a 2 minus x term. Well, if x equals 2.32, there's no way that's going to work. So we can eliminate this and say this is our workable root. Okay. And so the question was, what are the final concentrations? So we'll say the concentration of H2 is 1 minus 0.935. Concentration of I2 is going to be 2 minus 0.935. And the concentration of HI is 2x, and that's then 2 times 0.935. Okay, so H2 0.065, I2 1.065, and the HI comes out to 1.87. Now the test for this is to plug it back into the equilibrium constant expression and see if we in fact get 50.5. So remember again, KC equals the HI squared over H2 and I2. And so this is 1.87 squared divided by 0.065 times 1.065. And voila, we get 50.5 back. So there you go. An actual math calculation that is useful in a chemistry class.